Hey guys, I'm gonna be doing something a little bit different today. This is gonna be an unboxing, and I'm not gonna tell you what's in here. It's something as an avid sim racer that I should have gotten a long time ago, and I don't really know why I didn't. I don't want to give away too much right now. I'm gonna go ahead and just try to open this and see. I may have to cut it open with scissors, but I decided to go ahead and get it before they become unattainable, because they're for a brand new unopened copy. It's in the area of, now I'm gonna have to cut it. It's in the area of $130 for this, and well, I didn't get a mint copy. I went to like the highest quality used, but it comes in, this is supposed to be in the original big box, and hopefully full documentation and everything. And there it is. Let's see what this says. Oh, it's taped on the front. I don't like that. Thank you for the purchase. If you have any problem, don't hesitate to contact me at. And there's an email. I will try my best to fix the problem. If you have a problem leading or loading, try using compatibility mode. To do this, go to YouTube and type in set a compatibility mode. All right, that's a little helpful note. I wish they hadn't taped it to the front of the box, though. I'm gonna worry about that later. But there it is. You see what it is. I think it was just a situation where this was before online buying was a big thing, and let me give you a little better look of it here. And where I live, it's not exactly the most trendy area, and this may not have even been in stores much around here, especially being a Formula One game. I mean, I even had a little bit of a hard time. I mean, not really a hard time, but you didn't see NASCAR Racing 2003 everywhere, and I came late to the game on that. Just between you and me, I had a hacked version of it with an OCD crack that I had gotten, and I was playing that, and then finally I decided it was such a good game, and I think I actually wanted to start racing online. And at the time, you couldn't do any online racing in NASCAR 2003, with an OCD crack version. I think they checked version or something like that, or make sure it was there were no changes to any of the game files. So I ended up picking that up for, I think it was $29 at a local Kmart here of all places. But so I finally went and got this. Box is a little bit banged up around the edges here. Let's open this up. Oh, beautiful. See if, make sure you can see most of that. I'm looking at it upside down. I got to get a better setup if I'm going to do any more of these kind of videos with my webcam that I just installed it from my computer, this new computer I have, which actually isn't new anymore, but I hadn't had a webcam for like 2 or 3 years. I dug my old webcam out and installed it to do this video, and so yeah, there you see some really neat stuff there. A little bit about, let me turn this around here and read a little bit about it. Not bad shape, actually. It's just a little, got there's a little bit of like, you know, that wear where it was slid around on a table or stored on a shelf or something. But it talks about the era of racing that they're representing with this sim. This is probably the granddaddy of modern sims. Indianapolis 500, the simulation from like 1989 being the previous granddaddy of sims. And yeah, this is something else. So I can't wait to install this. I had played this, but I did it by the look at the back here too. There's the back. A little closer view of some of it. It's got some screenshots from the actual game. Some testimonials by different PC gaming publications. Pretty cool stuff. Features. It says here, oh, at the time it definitely did, the most accurate vehicle dynamics model ever developed for a racing simulation. Gorgeous 16-bit graphics optimized for 3D FX and rendition. A wow, resolutions up to 1024 by 768. Remember 3D FX people? I do. I had one of my video cards that I bought specifically because it had that. And there were some games that I was playing that used 3D FX, and I can't even remember what the games were anymore. You know, now after all this passage of years, 11 of the greatest racing circuits in history, including the 14-mile Nürburgring, historic Spa, and Monaco. 5 classic Grand Prix cars, including the Ferrari 312, Lotus Ford 49, Gurney Eagle, each with authentic 3D cockpit and performance characteristics. And since then, since this 1024 by 768, I think they may have upped that. With some created after video enhancements for the game, not by the company, but by, I guess, by people, programmers that were sim racers that knew how to create updates for video improvements of an existing game engine. So I'm gonna have to check those out too. Probably going to be a week or so before I get this running. I haven't really looked into it too much. I know there's a whole bunch of things you can do, and there's a few things you have to do, kind of like that note that I read on the front about if it doesn't load, you got to maybe change the compatibility mode, because this game, obviously, Windows 7 and even Windows, what, XP is the one before that, or Vista, I can't remember. Those weren't around when this was made. This was back in the Windows 98 era of games, I believe, or of days. Let's see. Does it have? Oh, here we go. Recommendations. Minimum requirements. Yeah, Windows 95, 98, Pentium 166, 32 megabytes of RAM, double speed CD-ROM. And a Windows 95 and 80 compatible video card with 2 megabytes of memory. So it actually did. That's pretty steep for the day. I think there were some games that weren't really requiring much memory on board with your video card. modem requirements, 100% Haze compatible. 28.8K or faster high speed or high speed serial card. Seriously? Wow, I had forgotten about dial-up modem. So yeah, this was back when I had a Haze compatible modem at one time, and me and a friend of mine used to connect I think it was IndyCar Racing 2 by Papyrus, and we used to is this the right way? Yes, it's the right way. Probably not going to be able to read all that. on the requirements or anything. It's just not focusing. But yeah, that's the bottom of the box where it has the requirements. But yeah, so we raced another Sierra game on a modem. We had to do all kinds of, we had to create some kind of a special modem string that you loaded up in DOS or something like that. It was a nightmare. And finally, we were able to get it hooked up and do some good racing and IndyCar racing too. And I think even some NASCAR, what would it have been at the time? NASCAR 2 or NASCAR 3. I don't even think NASCAR 4 was out at that time when I was racing on a modem. So, anyway, guys, I'm going to open this up here and make sure there's everything in there. I haven't neglected to even do that yet, so. Let's see. Looks like it's got all the original stuff in it. Set the box aside here. There it is. Original jewel case, it looks like, or a replacement jewel case, because this one looks like it's not had hardly any use. It's like no, you can see in the reflection, there's like no scratches or anything on this virtually. So they could have gotten another jewel case and put the sleeve or the that looks all really. It might be the original one because this looks beautiful inside. This is. And the disc, that disc is not showing. It looks brand new. That CD, I don't know what the other side of the CD looks like, but there's the CD right there. And it's, you can see in the reflection, that looks really good. It looks really good. And look, even the paper that came in the, in the jewel case, it just looks, everything looks pristine almost. I don't care, the box isn't that important to me. This is the most important part. Let me take this out now and try to see what this looks like. That CD looks perfect. Guys, this looks perfect. Just a couple little flecks of dust on this. I'm not even going to worry about that right now. I'm just going to put it back in there. And what's on the back? It's even got the back. Grand Prix Legends. When power slides and four-wheel drifts were the style of the day. And then it goes through the key features again and the requirements. Yeah, so there's that. Well, it's going to be hard to see with the reflection. Back of the jewel case. Everything looks just gorgeous. And it looks like it has all the documentation. It even has... Wow. This is actually a Sierra... I wonder if this was from England. Because this card has... has a UK address on it. It's the, is it the registration card? Yeah. This is the warranty, the original warranty card. And it has sierraonline.co.uk right there. So this, I'm thinking this came from England. Maybe not now, but at one time. Unless they're, I don't know, because maybe they were all, I don't think they were all like that, because I know. Cendant Software. It's Cendant Software. CENDANT. That might have been the UK distributor for Sierra Papyrus. I don't know. Some of you guys might know. But it has that. It has an addendum. It talks about 3D FX Voodoo 2 chipset. Yeah, that's another thing too. I'm gonna have to download some kind of a video thing that's gonna let my modern video card run it in, because this was made for old video architecture. Wow. Wow, it's got two books in here. It's got. This is really cool. Check this out. Flip them around here. Almost dropped one of them. It's hard to do this with. I gotta get a better camera set up. So yeah, one is Grand Prix Legends Game Guide right here. Everything's kind of mirror image for me. And this one over here is. It's titled Four Wheel Drift Grand Prix Legends by Steve Smith. This is a car guy's guide to Papyrus's Grand Prix Legends. So, and they look gorgeous. They look almost as perfect as the jewel case and the CD. Definitely better than a box. This is great, guys. I'm actually really happy with. Assuming that this thing will run, I'm really happy with the quality of everything. It's got everything original, as far as I know. I don't think anything's missing from this that I can think of. Even the warranty cards here. Just like getting it. It's like a time capsule. It's like a sim racing time capsule for a legendary game. A legendary racing sim. So, yeah, that's about it, guys. I'm gonna close it up. I'll be definitely doing some videos of this, assuming I can get it installed and working on my modern PC. And so look for that. I've been wanting to do it, and I've been having trouble getting the GPL 2004 demo running and adding the tracks manually like that. But I found a video the other day on how to get Grand Prix Legends running on your computer, and so I'm going to check that out in the next week or so. I'm not sure exactly when. It depends on work schedules and other things that I get into. I'll let you know, and look for content on that. Try to do some races in that, and get it all updated into modern, as modern graphics as we can go. And so just watch for that content, and I can't wait to do it. I just can't wait to get this running. So anyway, guys, I want to close up shop for now. And thanks for watching. Hope you liked it. If you can pick up a copy and you're a true sim racer like I am, I would recommend you do so before they're gone. If you don't have one already, because there were limited numbers that I found on Amazon, and even as they're resold, if people get tired of playing them or whatever, in the coming years, some are going to get destroyed, or they're going to stop working, and eventually they're going to be all gone. And get one while it's hot. And this one was only, I think it was, I got it for $50, which is, it probably only retailed for probably about $29 or $39. I don't really know right now offhand. But I'm sure that I paid more for it than the original purchase price. But at least I got it. So there you go, guys. Like and subscribe. Look for future content. And if you want to keep updated when I do post new stuff, click that little notification bell. And I'll be seeing you guys around.